الحمد لله، نحمده سبحانه ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه، ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهدي الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله وصفوته من خلقه وحبيبه، قد بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الغمة وجاهد في سبيل دينه حتى أتاه اليقين، فاللهم اجزه عنا وعن والدينا وعن الإسلام والمسلمين خير ما جازيت به نبيا عن قومه ورسولا عن أمته. اللهم أحينا على سنته وأمتنا على ملته، واحشرنا تحت لوائه وأوردنا حوضه، واسقنا من يده الشريفة شربة هنيئة لا نظمأ بعدها أبدا. اللهم آمين. أما بعد، فهناك أحاديث كثر في موضوع علامات الساعة، نذكر منها اليوم ما استطعنا في الوقت المحدد. فقد روى الإمام أحمد وابن ماجه وغيرهما عن أبي هريرة وأنس بن مالك رضي الله عنهما قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم: ستكون أو ستأتي أيام خداعات أو سنوات خداعات، يصدق فيها الكاذب ويكذب فيها الصادق، ويؤتمن فيها الخائن ويخون فيها الأمين، وينطق فيها الرويبضة. قالوا: وما الرويبضة؟ قال: الرجل التافه يتكلم في أمر العامة. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, there will be deceptive years that will come before the day of judgment. Those deceptive years will be so deceptive that the truthful man will be treated like a liar, and the liar will be treated like a truthful man. The honest will be treated as dishonest, untruthful. And the dishonest will be entrusted and will be treated as the most honest among people. And the last one, he says, وَيَنْطِقُ فِيهَا الرُّوَيْبِضَةِ. And the talk will be open for الرُّوَيْبِضَةِ. الرُّوَيْبِضَةِ will be given the stage. They will be speaking and they will be heard. They will be given audience. So in this hadith, the Prophet ﷺ describes some of the minor signs of the Day of Judgment, saying that a person who is known for being a liar will be accepted as a truthful man. And the person who is dishonest will be accepted as the most honest among people. And the truthful man will be rejected, the honest man will be rejected, and the one who speaks truth, he will be ostracized. I hope that we can all see those signs. But now there is a question: why did the Prophet ﷺ speak about those signs in details? The Prophet ﷺ is telling us about those details before they had happened, not because they never happened. They happened before. Pharaoh was believed to be what he claimed to be, أنا ربكم الأعلى, I am your Lord the highest. And other people over the ages, they rejected their prophets and they believed the liars of their community, those who wanted to mislead them, those who didn't work or want their interest, they did not put it at heart. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is not just telling this to observe it, but to observe it and to stop it and to bring the norm. And the norm is Muslims believe the truthful one. Muslims respect the honest one. Muslims protect the voices of the free people, not the voices of the deceptive people. Why did the Prophet ﷺ describe those years as deceptive years? It is because the truth gets lost. You don't know who is telling the truth, and everything becomes one and the same. People start confusing truth for falsehood and falsehood for truth. يلبسون الحق بالباطل. They confuse truth for falsehood and falsehood for truth. Why? Because of listening to the lies, listening to the deception. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala warned us Muslims, saying, وَفِيكُمْ سَمَّاعُونَ لَهُمْ. And he described a nation that came before us, a community that came before us, saying, سَمَّاعُونَ لِلْكَذِبِ سَمَّاعُونَ لِقَوْمٍ آخَرِينَ. They are listening to the liars. They are listening to others, not to their own Muslim brothers and sisters. This is part and parcel of the signs of the Day of Judgment. Our Ummah has to wake up, and this hadith is a wake-up call. We know, as I mentioned, that lying has always been as old as mankind. But when lying is massively accepted, this is what the hadith is pointing out, that the lie replaces the truth, and the dishonesty replaces honesty. And it's quite unfortunate that even us Muslims, we start talking to the truthful ones, to the honest ones, saying, Akhi, please be patient, things will work out, as if things work out on their own. And indeed they do. But when they do, they are not gonna do what we have to do. We have to establish truth. We have to establish honesty. After all, the other hadith of the Prophet ﷺ, when he was asked by one of the companions, when is the hour? And he says, sallallahu alayhi wasallam, إذا ضيعت الأمانة فانتظروا الساعة. When trust is squandered, when people who are in positions of power squander the trust handed to them by Allah and or by the community, they do not keep their trust, they do not keep their word, they do not fear Allah in what they are doing. This is what we have seen and we have been seeing all over our Ummah, and we must speak against it. This is the minimum. مَنْ رَأَى مِنْكُمْ مُنْكَرًا فَلْيُغَيِّرْهُ بِيَدِهِ فَإِنْ لَمْ يَسْتَطِعْ فَبِلِسَانِهِ فَإِنْ لَمْ يَسْتَطِعْ فَبِقَلْبِهِ وَذَلِكَ أَضْعَفُ الْإِيمَانِ. أو كما قال صلى الله عليه وسلم, anyone who sees something wrong, he or she should change it by their own hands, if they can. If they can't, they change it by their word. They denounce it. They expose it. They spread the word against it. And if they cannot do that, then at least they denounce it in their heart. فَبِقَلْبِهِ. And this is the least requirement of our faith. So brothers and sisters, here is the responsibilities laid down on our shoulder by none other than the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, to stand up for truth and to speak truth to power and to force each other to accept the truth and support it. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us truthful people who stand with truth and honesty. الحمد لله وكفى والصلاة والسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى, وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله وصفوته من خلقه وحبيبه، اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله وصحابته ومن اتبع سنته بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. Brothers and sisters, lies are leading. We know that through lies, wars are waged. Through lies, wars are won and lost. Through deception, rumors, innuendos. And it is on us, the minimum you could do is to denounce it in your heart and to expose it to people around you, those who believe and those who don't. Because unless we change what is going on, it is not gonna change on its own except to the worse. We know that Hitler killed millions of people just based on lies and innuendos, fabrications and rumors. And he thought he's a winner, but he's a worse loser. Brothers and sisters, we need to stop the lies that end up killing people, destroying homes. We need not to communicate lies, not even in a joke. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to laugh and even make jokes, but not based on a lie. He would always be truthful. He would not fabricate a story to make people laugh. What is ar-ruwaybida? The people who will be speaking more than all else close to the Day of Judgment. Ar-ruwaybida, as defined in the hadith of the Prophet, is a person who is a fool. He cannot make good judgment. He doesn't have knowledge, but he is speaking anyway because he is given the mic. He is given the audience and the ears. We need to only allow people who speak truth always to be our leaders, our speakers, because our ummah needs nothing more than truthful leaders, transparency, honesty, and integrity to lead our ummah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala fix our situation and help us fix it. Allahumma ahdina fi man hadayt, wa afina fi man afayt, wa tawallana fi man tawallayt, wa qina wasrif anna sharra ma qadayt. اللهم اقسم لنا من خشيتك ما تحول بي بيننا وبين معصيتك، ومن طاعتك ما تبلغنا به جنتك، ومن اليقين ما تهون به علينا مصائب الدنيا. ومتعنا اللهم بأسماعنا وأبصارنا وقوتنا ما أحييتنا. اللهم اشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين، وارحم موتانا وموتى المسلمين، واغفر ذنوبنا أجمعين، واغفر لإخواننا المسلمين. اللهم ثبت علماءنا وثبت مجاهدينا وثبت قولة الحق فينا. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم، فستذكرون ما أقول لكم، وأفوض أمري إلى الله. إن الله بصير بالعباد. وأقم الصلاة.